Welcome back to Closing Bell. I'm Juliet Powell. Since being sold last year to the Cambridge Group, the Willowdale Club Fitness has undergone some major renovations. In fact, that's just one of the group's latest projects in the fitness club industry. Here to tell us more is Clive Caldwell, the CEO of the Cambridge Group. Tell us about the investments that you've made in these three different fitness centers and the timeline for return on investment.
Well, we bought the three clubs from the Heinz Corporation last summer. Mm-hmm. And we put about $700,000 or $800,000 into the three clubs, and all done actually under the direction of an old friend, Paul Cranston, who is a figure skater by trade. And we've just upgraded these facilities and brought in new equipment and just refurbished the clubs. And we really expect to have this thing paid off in the next 2 or 3 years, all of the investment that we've done in the clubs. And so far, it's been a really strong result over the last 8 or 9 months since we've taken it.
What are you judging the result on?
Growth in membership. Mm-hmm. That's really the whole club business, whether it's a golf club or a dining club or a fitness club. It's really about membership. And they had really, because the H.J. Heinz company were just so big, they weren't really paying a lot of attention to it. So it's just cleaning things up, solidifying the business, and then growing the business.
You mentioned Tolar Cranston. What has he added to the project as a consultant?
Well, he's acted as an interior designer, fundamentally. So we have...
From skater to interior designer,
absolutely.
Huh? Okay.
Well, he's an artist by trade, as you may know now, and he and I have been friends for 30 years, and we've been doing this really for 15 years, starting with the Adelaide Club in the mid-80s. Uh-huh. And we've got six clubs, one in Montreal and five here in Toronto now. And he really has acted as an interior designer for all of the clubs. And that's really colors and materials. He'll buy furniture and lighting for us and paintings all over the clubs. We really try to have these at a much higher level than most of the fitness clubs that you'll go to. And just walking in, you just get a sense of that. And a lot of that is the work that he's done.
A lot of people are talking about spin classes. They seem to be extremely popular right now, especially the ones that have the live DJs while people are working out. Are you going in that direction? Do you follow trends like that?
Yeah, I mean, you're trying to stay current for sure. And the spinning environment has been around now for 3, 4, 5 years. Mm-hmm. And as you say, it's a very, you know, popular part of a health club today.
But it changes. These trends seem to change on an almost cyclical basis. How closely do you follow them as opposed to just staying the course?
I think staying the course is still really what we're about. Mm-hmm. But again, you want to stay current. So spinning looks like and felt like that it was going to be a long-term part of this industry, and we did it quite quickly. I think certain things and certain pieces of equipment, you've got to be careful not to waste your money and find that 6 and 12 months down the road, there's no interest in it. But I think it's like any business. If you're not staying current, you're not staying up to date, tomorrow is trouble.
So how often do you, is there a turnover in terms of your equipment?
Yeah, I mean, I think probably over a 4 to 6, 7 year period, you're probably turning over most of your equipment in a club. Mm-hmm. They get heavy use. These manufacturers are all trying to stay up to date and stay current themselves, so you've got to just keep your eye on that ball all the time.
And so how much do you charge for membership if the members are in fact the ones who are enjoying it and paying for it?
Yeah, we would be anywhere from $89 a month to $150, $160 a month, depending on the club.
Right. All right. Well, thank you very much. Congratulations in your endeavors.
Thank you very much.